welcome to the Nimbaru Black History Month kickoff ceremony and dinner. I'd like to thank Ms. Carswell, the assistant director. My name is Anissa, a sophomore economics major, as well as a student ambassador here at the Nimbaru Cultural Center.
Hi, everybody. My name is Jaden Ajay. I am a junior architecture student. So, as we all know, February 1st marks Black History Month, and we, the Nimbaru Cultural Center, want to use this time to reflect and celebrate our history. So, tonight, we hope you guys learn something and that you guys have a good time. Sound good?
I'd like to start off tonight's event by a tribute and song with Lift Every Voice and Sing with our very own Miss Sierra Hall, senior hearing and speech science major. Everyone, please give a round of applause for Miss Sierra Hall.
Thank you, Anissa, for that wonderful introduction. The words are on the back of your program, so please feel free to sing along and follow along. Lift every voice and sing till earth and heaven ring. Ring with the harmonies of liberty. Let our rejoicing rise high as the listening skies. Let it resound loud as the rolling sea. Sing a song full of the faith that the dark past has taught us. Sing a song full of the hope that the present has brought us. Facing the rising sun of our new day begun, let us march on till victory is won. Let us march on till victory is won.
Thank you very much.
Another round of applause for Sierra Hall, everybody.
Come on, Sierra.
Thank you, Sierra. That was amazing. Now I'd like to welcome to the stage Dr. Ronald Ziegler, the director of the Nimbaru Cultural Center, for the welcome and acknowledgements.
Thank you. Thank you, Nisa and Jaden. Welcome to the Nimbaru Cultural Center. On behalf of the Nimbaru Cultural Center, I would like to thank our entire campus community for coming out to this evening's Black History Month kickoff. To our community of students, faculty, and staff who are attending our event tonight, sponsored by the Nimbaru Cultural Center in collaboration with the student organizations that you will see on the very front of your programs, please make note of that, because they are an integral part of our department, as many other organizations are as well. Tonight's program, as previously mentioned, was coordinated by Ms. Ann Carswell, the Associate Director of the Nimbaru Cultural Center, along with myself as the director. Other extremely important staff members: Mr. Solomon Kamajan, Assistant Director of Student Involvement and Public Relations; Mr. Andre Nottingham, Assistant Director for Program Development and Advancement; and Mr. Quentin Wilson, the Technical and Operations Coordinator. In addition to our staff, our full-time staff that is, we have our two grad assistants, Mr. Shiva Malajala and Ms. Karishma Sheikh, And last but certainly not least, our Nibiru ambassadors, who are an integral part of our department. And they are the ones who really make us drive and motivate us along with our students. To our faculty and staff, I thank you for coming out. I'd like to also acknowledge Dr. Stephanie Chang for the Office of Diversity and Inclusion. And I'd like for all of our staff or faculty who are here, including Chief Mitchell and all the officers, please stand, if you don't mind. Give them a round of applause. Okay, and any other faculty and staff who might be here. Okay, again, to our students, we thank you. In closing, I'd like to acknowledge or mention that the theme for Black History Month, African Americans and the Arts, is the theme that you see here, I guess, kickoff and dinner, or we will see. And we will have a very strong representation of that tonight that you can see in your program, starting out through song with our keynote speaker, Mr. Torrin Washington, Sister Pat, and Mr. Frankie Jarvis. Hope I didn't mispronounce that. So they will definitely, and also our very own Sierra Hall, whom you just heard a moment ago. So you should enjoy tonight's program. Am I right?
Yes.
Okay. Thank you very much. Enjoy the program.
Ladies and gentlemen, please give a round of applause for Dr. Ronald Ziegler. Up next, to give the Black History Month national theme for 2024, please welcome our fellow ambassador in Junior Information Studies, Sciences, my bad. Gotta make sure it's right. Stephanie Lyon, please
Hi everyone. So right now I'll be reading the Black History Month national theme. African American art is infused with African Caribbean and the Black American lived experiences. In the fields of visual and performing arts, literature, fashion, folklore, language, film, music, architecture, culinary, and other forms of cultural expression, the African American influence has been paramount. African American artists have used art to preserve history and community memory as well as for empowerment. Artistic and cultural movements such as Black Arts, Black Renaissance, Hip Hop, and Afrofuturism have been led by people of African descent and set the standard for popular trends around the world. In 2024, we examine the varied history and life of African American arts and artisans. In celebrating the entire history of African Americans and the arts, the Association for the Study of African American Life and History puts into the national spotlight the richness of the past and present with an eye towards what the rest of the 21st century will bring. ASALH dedicates its 98th annual history theme to African Americans in the arts.
Thank you, Stephanie. Now, I would like to introduce our musical performance for tonight. Hailing from Guyana, South America, Sister Pat has been rocking audiences worldwide with an array of R&B, reggae, and soca styles, as well as performing with the world-renowned musicians Frankie Jarvis Sr., keyboardist extraordinaire, who was a native of the island of St. Martin and toured worldwide extensively with the legendary Wailers. Ladies and gentlemen, please give it up for Sister Pat and Frankie Jarvis.
Cute. Okay.
Yeah, there we go.
Do you like my outfit?
Yes.
It was a gift from the beautiful country of Cameroon. This is their traditional, they call it a togu, atogu. This is their traditional design. I felt it appropriate because many of us, our ancestors involuntarily took a cruise from Cameroon to the Americas, including Guyana. Yes, and I felt it appropriate, this introduction song from the Master Rasta Robert Nesta Marley, whose birthday is this month. Give peace a chance. I had a dream. Yes, they rob I, so light to the merchant ships. Minutes after they took I from the bottomless pit, but my hands were made strong by the hand of the Almighty. We forward in this generation, triumphantly. Oh, won't you help me sing these songs of freedom? 'Cause all I ever had, redemption song, emancipate yourselves from mental slavery. None but ourselves could free our minds. Have no fear for atomic energy, 'cause none of them can stop the time. Kill our prophets while we stand aside and look. Some say it's just a part of it. We're going to fulfill the book. Oh, won't you help to sing these songs of freedom? 'Cause all I ever had, redemption song. All I ever had, redemption song. These songs of freedom. Songs of freedom. I had a dream today. I've been to the mountaintop. Let freedom ring. Yes, 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 yes. We're celebrating African Americans. And you know I'm going to put a little Caribbean twist in there. And I feel like I wanna go home.
Yes!
Yes!
All right, all right. All right.
Wait a minute. The first gift, I mean, I don't know whether you all know Raven.
We got Baltimore Ravens mug. All right. They didn't make it to the Super Bowl, but you got the mug. All right. Next question. Why was February chosen as the month to celebrate Black history?
Is it because it aligned with the birthdays of Abraham Lincoln and Frederick Douglass?
This man right here, not Chase. That's an attack
of joy. Very good, very good. Hold on. What do we got for that gentleman? Can I ask you next? All right, there we go. All right. Next question. Who was the first president of Black Student Union at the University of Maryland? Who was the first president of the Black Student Union at UMD? Any wild guesses? Any wild? Hold on. How many people been here for about 20 years, 30 years, 40 years? You don't know the answer? Who's been here the longest here? Dr. Z, raise your hand. How long have you been here, sir?
42.
All right. Ms. Carswell, you been here how long?
42.
She can't answer the question, though, so he's also eliminated. So any others? Who's been here the next longest? How long?
29.
Who else? Chief, how long have you been on campus?
14.
Okay. Anybody top 29? Been on campus for more than 29 years? All right, okay.
All right, so we have another trivia question. Which one was not invented by an African-American? A, traffic light, B, street sweeper, C, iron, D, fountain pen.
Oh.
Traffic light? No. Anybody got any other guesses?
Right here.
Back up with the red.
D? The last one?
No.
Okay,
right here. Is it pen?
No.
All right. I forgot to give you the answer to the last question as far as who was the first president of the Black Student Union. That was Bob McLeod. So remember that for next year. Bob McLeod. All right. Next question. Who was the first African-American Nobel Peace Prize winner? First African-American Nobel Peace Prize winner. Any hands? Got a hand raised? Who was the first African-American Nobel Peace Prize winner? And I know what you think.
Is it MLK?
No, ma'am. Good thought, though. Good thought.
Hey, Anybody
else? Anybody else?
I had a choice.
Yes.
Who's that? Who you got?
I'm yes.
Who's guessing?
DJ.
Oh, you're eliminated. Anybody else? Anybody else? Hey, give me your next guess.
She's the only soul in here.
Who's the question?
Is it
Good dog, but no man. Who's that? Somebody said something.
It's not him. Give them
Round punch. There you go. There you go, right there. Round punch.
All right, so we have our last trivia question. Whose funeral resulted in the postponement of the 1968?
Oh, what was it you said?
whose funeral resulted in the postponement of the 1968? Sorry, that's what the question told me. I'm gonna get more information. A second.
We got a hand over here.
Oh, do we got
a hand? We got one hand right there. And we got a hand over here next. So straight back. Oh, she's Googling it. She's Googling it.
Don't go to anybody.
Am I okay?
Yeah,
she got it.
All right, right there.
All right, before we get to the last question here, everybody has a sign-in sheet on your tables. If you can make sure that you sign in on that sign-in sheet, everybody, and just pass it around your table. So every table has a sign-in sheet. So please take care of that. Thank you. All right. Where was the first sit-in in a segregated lunch counter? Now, they have some responses here, but I think if I say them, they'll give it away. Does anybody know the answer? All right, without getting a cheat code? No, what state? What city and state? What city and state? City and state. All right, we got a Brady Soul over here.
Selma?
No, ma'am. Good thought. She said Selma, Alabama. Who else? No, good thought. All right, question again. Where was the first sit-in in a segregated lunch counter? City and state. There you go, right there. There you go. Now, see, if I would have given you that, then you would have been able to know that. So, good. Greensboro, North Carolina. North Carolina A&T. They were students at North Carolina A&T. All right, well, thank you. All right. Thank you very much for the indulgence. We appreciate you all.
Contributions of black people led to the establishment of Black History Month, marked every February since 1976. Woodson fervently believed that black people should be proud of their heritage and that all Americans should understand the largely overlooked achievements of black Americans. So, the more you know. Alright. We would now like to introduce our keynote speaker. So please, welcome to the stage our fellow ambassador, and environmental science and technology major, Kai Diggs.
Good evening. I'm Kai Diggs, an Nimburu Cultural Center ambassador. And as Jake said, I'm an environmental science and technology major. It is my task today to introduce to you our keynote speaker, Mr. Torian Washington. Mr. Torian Washington holds a bachelor's degree in studio art from Hood College in Frederick, Maryland. Raised as a military child and enduring the challenging experiences in his upbringing, he was able to translate the vast changes and traumatic experiences into the work. As a result, the bold lines, vibrant colors, and thought-provoking subject matter is a product of how Torian was raised. It is Torian's goal as an artist to penetrate the times and create a paradigm shift. He stands on the shoulders of great artists. However, Torian wants to blaze new trails and reach uncharted territories as an artist and redefine what it means to be an artist in the modern era. As an African American who has emerged from a minimum wage position to earn six figures, Torian was on the longer route to achieve later success in life with his art and professional career. He was positioned against the grain to grab a slice of the American pie. With his art, Mr. Washington wanted to serve that slice of creative pie in an inclusive and diverse manner to everyone. Torian Washington is a resilient and driven entrepreneur and professional who achieves goals and conquers dreams. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you entrepreneur, Mr. Torian Washington.
Okay, how's everybody doing? I think it's just coincidental that Mr. Diggs is the one. He has the Ravens mug, and it was all good a week ago because Mr. Donahan brought it up like they were supposed to go to the Super Bowl, but they didn't. Unfortunately, like this week I was prepping, and then, you know, I thought I was going to have this, and everybody was like, yeah, we're going to the Super Bowl, but it just didn't happen, so, okay. All right, so before I go, I just want to thank Ms. Carslow for bringing me here. Just really, she's, like, I need you to give her a round of applause. She has such a kind heart, and I've known her since 2009. And actually, the students, that's why you guys, the students, are so special, because I was doing, like, a lot of painting at the Reginald F. Lewis Museum, and they had this thing called Poetic Fridays, and they had students out there and from University of Maryland College Park, and they would do these events, and they had me on, and then next thing you know, someone connected, like, hey, Ms. Carswell, you know, she's doing events, and they had Maryland Day, and that's how me and her connected. And so for a few years, I was doing caricatures, and we'd be able to develop a relationship there. So I want to thank Ms. Carswell for, out of all my heart, for just her kindness and being willing to have me here. So I'm here today talking about Black history and the arts from the view of an entrepreneur. So I call myself an entrepreneur. And so for me, allow me to introduce myself. So my name is Torian Washington, just as Mr. Diggs described so vividly. So I'm a man of God first, and also I'm a husband, 15 years next month. And my wife, she has three children. We have three children together, so she made the ultimate sacrifice. I was running late to get here, so I really appreciate her. So like I said, going to father, family member. So I had we had issues with the live stream because going to later in the presentation, I'll have stuff going on that I'll allude to, but I was having family members actually gonna watch me live stream, but due to the network, it was difficult, but I'll get to that. So entrepreneur, that's what I am. Also, I'm a dreamer, and I'm actually with my mission, I'm gonna be serving, I'm a servant, so. So, A-side, just like back in the day, you know, for me, I'm 38, so I'm like an elder millennial, so even before my time, it'd be like, oh, there's the tape, there's A-side, B-side, you know, so I kind of want to structure this, like, the first part is the art. These are just some samples of just out here, and I'll go in depth, but you have well-known artists. There's too much to name in this whole presentation of great artists throughout history, but I hope I give you a snapshot, because a lot of African Americans, even though I'm looking at visual medium, there's a vast medium from music, literary arts, dance. So you have so many different people. So I'm basically kind of covering my perspective from a visual standpoint, but there's just so many people, and even our performers tonight, that they cover that in the music medium. So there's so many types of art out there. So you have here, especially like groundbreakers, Amy Sherrill did the presidential portrait of Michelle Obama, along with Candy Wiley did Barack Obama, Ramir Bearden, a revered artist, as well as Faith Ringgold. And she's up there. She's living her golden years, but she's still strong. And in that piece itself, she's actually challenging one of the, you know, European greats, Picasso. So if you look at it, like, that's actually like her representing Picasso instead of the models that's from the Demoiselles d'Avignon. That's a well-known piece by Picasso. She has an African-American woman in the piece, like in the forefront, saying, hey, it's about me. Like she's blocking the shine from these, you know, the women that's been depicted and highlighted. So it's a lot of things that us as African-Americans and our voices that we're trying to say to challenge the status quo and the canon of European art. So I just wanted to highlight that to you. So just like I said before, there's a lot of people to name. So for me, I kind of had to break down the top three. So in this presentation, I have a top three artists that kind of segue into me. But these are kind of the honorable mentions. Jacob Lawrence is one of my guys. And I wanted to also, like I said, going from the past to the present, because like I said, we have a younger generation here present, and I want to acknowledge you there, so I don't want to give you like a whole like, and at the same time, I know that we have greats like Frederick Douglass and people of that nature, but also like, I want to have you in a modern context and some in the past as well. So I want to be that perfect bridge for everybody. So Jacob Lawrence, of course, back in that time, in the earlier times, Harlem Renaissance era, a little bit past Harlem Renaissance era, but definitely he did so many amazing things and contributions. I love his figurative work, very narrative. Like he always tells a story with his pieces. Like you look at his pieces, he always tells a story. Same with Kara Walker. Hers is very interesting with her stories, but she's actually, she's well known with her silhouettes, but with this picture right here, she like rented out this like factory, and she actually built like this, the mammy, figure out of sugar. So it was like temporarily up there for a little bit of time, because of course sugar is not gonna last forever. So it was, if you look it on YouTube, it's called a subtlety, but it's definitely not subtle. The message is not subtle. So it's almost like a sarcasm. She knows that sarcasm, the visual sarcasm when you look at her pieces. So first up, this is my guy. This is like my ultimate favorite artist of all time. And so for me, I'm a hip hop head. Like you have J. Cole there. So I actually have a series called Art Hop, the intersection of art and hip hop. So I like, but just how you have like, just even you want to give like an example of someone back in the 80s who knew like Run DMC, how they sampled rock and then they made from rock and hip hop together. Same thing what Robert Colescott did, and the term is called appropriation. So he took like well-known things from like the European canon and then made it his own and flipped it. So, you know, there's this like, I think it's like Edward, I'm trying to recall the artist's name, but basically you remember the old George Washington, the president, there's an infamous portrait of him on a boat, and he basically took that and flipped it, and he made, instead of George Washington, he made a George Washington Carver crossing the Delaware. And if you look in this piece, there's all these different things that he's saying in the piece. And then the same thing on the other side is called Emergency Room. And just like Jacob Lawrence, I like how Robert Colescott tells a story. And okay, so next up, this is one of my guys too. And of course, to you guys in the room, more of the younger people in the room, Jean-Michel Basquiat probably is a little bit more well known than what Robert Colescott I mentioned. But it also is because he's really transcended generations. And of course, if you see on the right, you have Jay-Z, Beyonce. Jay-Z, I mean, if you want to say people stealing styles, like Jay-Z has definitely stole Jean-Michel Basquiat's style, like his hair, everything. So, and if you hear his raps as a probably like post 2013-ish, he's been getting into being like an avid art collector. And that's kind of like what I feel like I was ahead of the curve with, because I noticed that there's something interesting about art and hip hop together. And so I actually have it, you know, it's in the process of being trademarked. And like I said, I've been doing this concept, art and hip hop. And so later this year, I'll actually have a book published, a nationwide book published called The Art Hop Manifesto. And I'll give examples of how I'll be doing art and hip hop together. So basically what I would do is I take a whole album, and I've done actually shows with this. Like I did a Kendrick Lamar album where I took each painting as a song. So I did To Pimp a Butterfly, and every song was an interpretation of that, you know, every painting was an interpretation of the song, and together the series is an album. So with Jean-Michel Basquiat, I really love just what he did. It looks like he's a child did it, but it's way more complex, way more intricate, and no one could have done what he did. Like he actually had he passed away sadly at like around 27, but like his production level, like he produced so much in a short span of time that he was alive. So he's definitely one of my heroes. Nina Shannon Abbey. So don't think, ladies, I haven't left you out, because like I said, like there's many artists like Carrie Mae Weems, Lorna Simpson, like so many talented women as well that I look up to in their work. And for me, Nina Chanel, she's really paving the way. Like she's doing a lot of partnerships with, like, I think she recently did something with Timberland, the boots. Then she also had like a deal with Uno, the cards. She does like NFTs. This right here, I mean, most popular, she was doing Jordan. She actually partnered with Jordan. She has her own Jordan sneaker. And then she actually designs Meek Mill's album cover, one of his album covers. So if you look that up, those are in the hip hop, like I said. But she But her, she, like I said, she does a commentary. For me, I'm a storyteller. Just like with hip-hop, I like lyrics, stories. So that's what I really gravitate to, also with art. So Nia Chanel, she's very talented as well. So me, this is, you know, this is what I do. I wanted to kind of give a couple examples. I have a lot of different styles. I purposely chose this because it is a theme of African Black History Month. So what I did was I came up with, for this month, I have a series, the Black History series. And so I basically have the men and women, like they basically have a whole series of all them together, but they're charcoal drawings. And then I use the graphic background and the text, but actually each of these are actually individual charcoal drawings, but I just took the heads out and put them on in the background. So these themselves are images and they'll be prints. And actually this month on the 17th, I'll be at the Slayton House in Columbia, Maryland for a pop-up exhibition. And there'll be free food. It's actually be catered for 300 people. I'm gonna have music, a soul singer, and then also Escaparam Power County Executive Kyle Ball will be there. And so it's gonna be a big event, but I'm just excited to where we can really showcase, and highlight and celebrate our history. And so I wanted to just have like I said, a little bit of past and present. So you see Kamala Harris, you see Ketanji Jackson, but then again you see LeBron James, then you see Malcolm X, Martin Luther King, then you have Chadwick Boseman, you have Sean Carter, AKA Jay-Z. So that's what I wanted to show. But then also in the middle, I wanted to show you one of my pieces. Like I said, God is a source for me, so I wanted to show one of my pieces of basically my take on Rosie the Riveter, like the old poster. Remember, we can do it. So I flipped it and said, like, I can do all things. But then I also wanted to touch base on, like, I wanted to showcase, like, in terms of, like I have my wife, I have my mom, I have my sister, and I see, like, you know, they'll tell me stories on just the differences on their experience in the workplace compared to a man. Like, it's almost like the ranking of, like, white male, white woman, black woman. So it's like, or certain things like that, where, like, my wife would kind of tell me the experience of that. And so and then you think about the equality and pay. So, and then also I think about just the empowerment, like, what we can do through Christ, you know. So I kind of thought about that, and so instead of just having it as a political thing in terms of the bubble, I put it more of a religious context. But then at the same time, I wanted to give power, and then if you look at the scarf, instead of making a regular scarf like it was a Rosie the Riveter, I made it more of an Afrocentric scarf. So I kind of try to have it from that perspective, from our perspective, so from the diaspora. So yes, B-side, entrepreneur. So art and entrepreneur. So I'm almost at the end, but so my company is called Touring Washington Studios, and how Mr. Diggs was trying to, was explaining about what I want to do is in terms of redefining what it means to be an artist in the modern era. So right now I have Touring Washington Studios, that's the basis, like the top, and I'm going to have, in this year, I'm going to have 9 different entities under that umbrella. So the first portion is art, entertainment, media, and we had issues having the live stream, but basically next month is going to be a premiere of on smart TVs, creator-led platform, and it's going to be $3 a month where you see film, music, animation, all that in one. It's creator-led, and so for me, I want to be an artist outside of just the canvas. I want to be an artist also in business. And at the same time, there's a way to where I can have artists be compensated and we own our content and not be taken from, on the other end. And I wanted to show you this.
Man.
This is called Halftime. I don't know if I'm gonna start right away. This actually came today.
I was at a film night developing me as an artist, but more than that, a person. My hurt, struggle, pain, despair, and heartache has become the very same thing that's given me power. My name is Torrin Washington, and this is Halftime. 90% of sales will go to Black Lives Matter in February 2024. 30% after that, it's game time.
Okay, so I know we're to the next slide, but so Halftime, I actually dropped a book today. It came out today on Amazon. It's pending with Barnes & Nobles, also Busboys and Poets. So it's going to be nationwide distributed. And so basically what it is, Halftime, I'm big into basketball, so really like you saw that symbol was like the Air Jordan, but instead of the ball, he saw it in a paintbrush. So I did the silhouetted figure. So for me, I feel like the team on the opposite end was, you know, they're beating me and I'm trailing in points. So halftime, I'm trying to strategize, like, what am I gonna do? How am I gonna win this game? So the book is a retrospective of my work from ages 7 to 37. So I'm 38 now. So it's about an 82-page book, and you'll see all my work from the past to the present, and then I give you some snapshots into the future, and it's just kind of letting people know what's to come. And so, like I said, in the commercial, and what you see here, for what I want to do is make history in Black History Month. 90% of my sales will go to Black Lives Matter. And I've already been conversing with Cicely Gay in Atlanta. She's one of the leaders in Black Lives Matter. It's not an official partnership yet in terms of where she's like, we're gonna actually like jointly collaborate, where it's like she's gonna press the button, but we're still in talks, and we have a meeting next week. So you may see something in mass media where there could be something where it's out there, but regardless, if it's not, then I'm still gonna do my part and just give at the end of the month. But that's my mission, is to where I want to do something so great with Black history, and these guys have been on the front lines for our community, and I want to use my tool of art for activism. So what I have tonight that's at the table, what I have here on display, and if you see right there, that's actually one of the dedication piece right there of Black Lives Matter. So you see, you know, our fallen individuals in the community, that were tragically, taken from us. And what I wanted to do is like honor them, and basically kind of going back to how Robert Colescott did with like appropriation. If you see back in the day, like in the like 1400s, 1500s, where they had those religious paintings and the angels had the different colors, I actually did like the Pan-African colors, the red, green, and black. And you know, so I kind of wanted to kind of, you know, allude to kind of like the unity of our people. And then at the same time, they had the halos, and then I had the BLM and the black hearts, and then I had part at the bottom, you see like kind of part of like the striving for liberation, like part of that mission statement of Black Lives Matter. So I wanted, that's kind of like the, you know, so the Breonna Taylor, George Floyd, Trayvon Martin, I put that all together. And then if you see on Trayvon Martin, because he was so innocent, you think about like the Skittles, instead of like the S, I have the cross, you know, on each of those colors. So, so this is kind of back to what I was saying about the upcoming show. It's actually gonna be, like I said, it's gonna be at the Slate House, Columbia, Maryland, catered food and drinks, music performances, amazing art. And I hope to see you guys there. Like I said, it's actually gonna be airing on Fox 45 in the morning and prime time that week of the 11th to the 17th. So I have a videographer working on that commercial. And so you'll probably see it on Fox 45 Baltimore, that's actually a news station. So for me, this is my closing remarks. You know, I'm gonna speak from the heart because I feel like people, like, there's so much that, you know, that's against us. Like, I remember before even, like, starting the year, I saw the, I'm trying to pronounce his name, like, Ibrahim Kendi, and I'm sorry if I botched his name, but I saw that Stand from the Beginning on Netflix, and just, I remember that segment about Phyllis Wheatley and, like, how they didn't, like, believe that she was actually capable of writing poetry, you know, based on who she was. And then just not thinking that we were intellectually capable or having the capability of producing something of higher level compared to our Caucasian, European, white counterparts. So, and I feel like it's about equality. Like, all of us are human at the end of the day. And I think that no matter what field you're in, art, science, like anything is possible. And so for me, there's no limitation for me. Like, I see that list, like, you know, you're looking at the scoreboards in terms of like income and finances, you see the top 10 richest people, no people of color, not even just like that, not like black people, just any people of color. It's just, you see all the different dynasties, the Waltons, the Arnaults, the Sacklers, all those people. Why can't there be an African American or someone of descent of color there? Like, they're, you know, we have maybe 3 billion, 4 billion, 1 billion, but why not 150 billion, you know, why not Elon, why not Jeff Bezos? That's possible. It's only in your mind, and that's what I believe, and I'm going to be here and have that mission to help serve, and I want to bring others with me, my community with me, and I think that just being creative, you can do and achieve anything, and from where I came from to be where I'm at today, it's just a testament, like, just everything in time. Like, to be honest with you, I wasn't even supposed to be here. I wasn't the selected guest. I wasn't even on the, you know what I mean? It was just in Miss Carswell's mind, like, wait a minute, someone wasn't there. And then, wait a minute, hey, you came in my mind. And then, in alignment, Advocate Carter G. Wilson, just like it was said, the African-American in the arts, just so happened, I'm an African-American art, or basically, you know what, this is what I want to say, that's what I said in the book, in the forward, I said, don't put black in front, that's the identifier, put artist of this, lawyer of this, because when you say you're a black lawyer, what's the difference of just being a regular lawyer? So I'm just saying, just be the profession or what you are, but it's not, don't, like, that you're being placed in another category as opposed to what's at the default. Like, we should all be at one level. So what I'm saying is, I'm just thankful for being here. Don't limit yourself. Whatever field you're in, you know, just go and achieve the hardest you can do. You're here for a reason, and I'm just thankful for you being here in this place with me. So that's all I have to say, so thank you. Wow.
Please give another round of applause for Mr. Washington. Now I'd like to welcome back to the stage Sister Pat and Frankie Gervois Sr. Everyone, please give a round of applause.
Thank you. Thank you once again, Mrs. Carswell, Mrs. Tula. Yes, we're going to end with. We were given two songs, and I chose these two. One is from that master Rasta, Robert Nesta Marley. And the second one, I need some dancing girls and guys to follow some instructions. But the second one, kind of toy, I'm gonna bring some of the islands here. Turn it down a wee bit. Thank you. All right, yes. Leave your troubles at the door. Don't you think about them anymore. Live and love and love and love and love and live. You better get it. Hey.
So don't worry about a thing. Cause everything gonna be alright. Melody pure and true, and singing, this is my best. dances floating. There ain't no hiding place for my father's drum. Sing it with the children. Sing it loud and clear now. One heart. Let's get this together and feel alright. Pray for peace on mankind. Boy,
I put it on the guy, he's accent no. Oh, you don't want to eat, eh? Come on, audience participation for this last song. My daddy was born in Trinidad. Frankie's from St. Martin. I'm from Guyana, South America. By the way, the moves that I'm about to teach you are from Africa. In West Indies, we call it a wine. It's like a West Indian hula. So, but zero cholesterol, zero fat calories, but plenty sugar, baby. Ding ding da, hug ding da, ding ding da, hug ding da, hug ding da, hug ding da, hug ding da. He loves how I move my body when I sing.
Da 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 da
Please give up for Sister Pat one more time.
That was fun, right? All right. Now we have now reached the blessing of the food. Before I say y'all had a good time tonight, y'all enjoy yourselves. All right. Before we close this off, actually, there's this fact I want to get out to the people. Garrett Morgan, did you know that Garrett Morgan was able to come up with extraordinary inventions which have a tremendous impact on society, including the first human hair straightener, improved sewing machines, and traffic light, and most notably, the gas mask. Morgan called the gas mask a safety hood and patented it as a breathing device. So, next time you can't breathe, think of Blappy. Oh, no way you know. Here's another one for you. George Crumb, who was the inventor of the potato chip, never patented or attempted to widely distribute his potato chips. Nevertheless, they were soon on their way to becoming an international phenomenon and a number of aspiring snack food entrepreneurs across the country. So next time you need a chip, think of Blackie. Good one, you know. Please welcome Ms. Andrews Carswell to bless the food.
Okay, before I bless the food, I would just like to thank Nisha, Jaden, Sierra, Dr. Ziegler, Stephanie, Sister Pat, and Mr. Frankie Senior, Bassarette, Mr. Andre Nottingham, and Kai. And of course, Mr. Torrin Washington, our keynote speaker. But before I bless the food, I would just like to, I know some of you may remember her. I would just to acknowledge that someone we used to have to do Kwanzaa, Black History Month, Closing Maryland Day, Gospel Happy Hour, just anything we asked her to do. And I think the last time, it was not the last time, it was the Juneteenth, but I remember when we was out for the, during the pandemic, we still was programming, so we had a virtual Juneteenth celebration. And she met me up here, we recorded, even though we had on our masks and stuff, but did it. She worked here at the University of Maryland for a long time, and her name is Angie Bass. And she organized the Exempt Talent Show. And she was a great singer. I still have those recordings of her saying, great singer. But anyway, she passed away, so just want to, for her, I would go to her family. Her funeral will be February 16th. So, Angie, rest in peace and keep singing up there. Okay, we're going to have two lines. As you can see in here, we have fried and rotisserie chicken, whiting, collard greens, and soul food, green beans, macaroni, cheese, yam, and cornbread muffins, sweet tea, and lemonade, water. So, dear Heavenly Father, I want to thank you for the food that we are about to receive. We ask that you strengthen, that it strengthen and nourish our bodies. And we ask that you remove all impurities as we pray in your name. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Okay. Any children? Line up first. Senior second. And student third.
What? Also, the sign-up sheet, for those that haven't signed in on
Sunday, yeah. Please do that. So. Yeah, I definitely need you to sign up. My guest, could you go up? All right, Chief Mitchell, do you all know the police? to know our chief of police here at the University of Maryland. Chief Mitchell, please stand. This is a person, a nice person, an office officer here. Captain Kenner, I better not start calling in the name because I may mess up. But anyway, Chief Mitchell, you can do that. You can introduce your staff.
Okay. Good evening, everyone. From the University of Maryland Police Department, we are honored to be here. With me tonight is the real Chief of Police, Captain August Kenner. Woo! This is Lisa Church.
August Kenner. You probably know August from seeing her around campus. Miss Lisa Church, she's one of our exceptional assistants to the chief. Captain David Fields.
Yes.
You see him sitting behind the men's basketball coach and so forth at the games. Major Ken Ecker. You see him behind the games. And Major Mike Ledbetter as well. Thank you, Ms. Cardwell. Thank you.
And also, while we had that, I did the, how many weeks was it, 13?
12.
12 weeks.
12, yeah.
It's called the Citizen Police Academy. So, we would like for students, we really need some students to do this. Mr. Nottingham and I, we both, and Ms. Church, we was in that class. I guess we call it the inaugural class.
Yeah.
So you learn so much about the police department. You may not be so critical about things when it happened. So when you see things, you got to understand. Sometimes you don't have that much time to think about what was going on. Now, that some things, some people do have time to think about. But anyway, I ain't gonna get into all of that. So, okay. So if you all want to see it in the office over there, if we'd like to do this class, please. Yes. I was supposed to get at least 5 people, and I haven't gotten anybody, so can y'all help me out?
We got one today.
Okay,
yes,
good.
Okay. Sign up. If you want to get pulled over by Ms. Carter, sign up. We'd love to have you.
Right. Yeah, I did have to do that little play act where I had my hands on the gun. It was like, why you got your hands on the gun? But anyway, okay. I'm going to just call tables. These 3 tables right here. Let's go. 2 lines. Can we make sure you have